the main thing, reason we wrote it is we felt there had been already 5,000 books written proving that UFOs were real. And that essentially is looking backwards, trying to look at the data that has been accumulated. We felt like writing a forward-leaning book, the first of its kind, that takes you past this moment that we're currently in where society has not quite come to grips with this reality, but after it, and what that will be like, because that's a good way to prepare for it, isn't it? So if you think about it, what Rich and I are arguing is that the calendar is going to shift to conform to this, and I want you to think about it using the calendar that we currently have. We live in a BC world. We live in a before confirmation world. This is the world of BC. But on the moment when mankind acknowledges publicly to itself that we are not alone, we will go from a BC world to an AD world, which will be the after disclosure world. And nothing will ever be the same after that. It's not like society as we know it will end, but society as we are going to know it will begin. And we thought the number one thing we could do is try to start that conversation with the world and with ourselves and get people talking about it, because whether we're ready or not, it's coming down the line sooner or later. I think we can all agree on that. So we want to be prepared for it. And the way to do that is to discuss it and to make it part of the content and fabric of what's going on in the world. To that end, one of the things we did is not only write the book, but we also created a site for essays by us and other people, and a chance to dialogue about this, and that's afterdisclosure.com. So it's just the title of the book, afterdisclosurerundogether.com. And there is one piece of news that I can tell you. The book was published in hardcover in October of 2010 and has sold quite well through Keyhole Publishing. But we have just agreed, Rich Dolan and I, to put out a career press version that will be widely available throughout the country and all the Barnes & Nobles and every other space available for the public sale of books. And that will be coming out from Career Press in May of 2012. And it will have new content as well, updated to include things like the disclosure petition that we're talking about today.
You have something else in the works. Can you tell me about the project that you have going on with After Disclosure?
Well, I have a couple of things. It's been an interesting year. My UFO career, I guess, such as it is I wrote the first original film about it for the Sci-Fi Channel, but also a television series, Dark Skies, which I did for NBC in the 90s, which just came out on DVD last year, finally. Thank you. That was great. And I realized, as all this was going on in my life and writing this book with Richard Dolan, I just realized that I'm not done expressing what I want to express about this, but what I want to see happen is a mainstream feature film that people will go to, not because it's a scary UFO movie, but because it's a good movie, just a really great, interesting story well told, and that when they come out of it, they'll be talking about this topic in a serious way. I want to be part of something that is a predicate to disclosure. And to that end, I'm working on a project called Magic Men, M-A-J-I-C, Magic Men. And it is based on the options to two books, one by Stanton Friedman, which is Top Secret Magic, and the other by Don Schmidt and Tom Carey, which is Witness to Roswell, and the life stories of Stanton Friedman and Don Schmidt. And Magic Men will tell the story of the Roswell competition, investigation, and how Roswell came to be part of our public consciousness through the eyes of the competition of Stanton Friedman and Don Schmidt, who basically led two different teams or two different wings of the UFO political parties as they tried to break this story in the 90s. So Magic Men was commissioned into script last January, and the script is now completed, and we are on the market trying to find a home for it. I think both Stan and Don Schmidt are true American heroes.
Sure.
And I would define an American hero as someone who just doesn't want to be lied to and will bear almost any price it takes to get at the truth. Because if you think about it, and this is why the movie I find so endlessly fascinating and why I think audiences will ultimately embrace it is, the matter of the potential cover-up of an extraterrestrial craft, that cover-up has had enormous durability and should have been investigated by the mainstream media. In other words, Woodward and Bernstein or their followers should have investigated UFOs, but they didn't. They took a pass for reasons that we could spend an hour talking about. But who had to step into the breach? A retired nuclear physicist, Stanton Friedman, and a postal clerk, Don Schmidt. Now, that to me is a fascinating story. It's the biggest story of all time, but because the establishment media has told itself that they don't believe in it, it doesn't get investigated or covered and has to be taken over by average citizens, which to me is a great story, a great American story. It's a great story of discovery, and I'm very compelled by it.
Well, I am too, and it's a sad state that the exposure that we've had to incidents like Roswell and across the board, the UFO subject isn't something that people take seriously, not just because of the influence of Hollywood, but also because, you know, if we disclose that there's aliens here, if we disclose that there's an extraterrestrial presence, it will cause every person on Earth to reevaluate their value systems, what they've been taught from birth, essentially. And on top of that, people are scared by nature and the change that's associated with it and the fear of what we believe. It is a very, very large wall to climb.
But John, what you're talking about is the entire book After Disclosure is on that very topic.
Correct.
And the website is on that very topic, which is, and I think that Rich Dolan and I are, you know, we're cynical, I guess, about the cover-up that has been in force for all these years. But we are disclosure optimists. We believe that it is, although it was once viewed as impossible, it's now inevitable. And we think it's the irresistible force of truth against the immovable object of secrecy, and that ultimately truth is going to prevail in this one. And to that end, it is true that certain disruptive events, we tried to give a lot of specific thought in After Disclosure to what these specific tumultuous events would be, but we came out feeling that ultimately we will probably be better off for it and life will go on and hopefully get a lot better. It depends on what some of the answers are as to who are they and what do they want, but that will all come out in the wash too, and it's better to know than to not know is I guess our take on things. But certainly some disruption will happen. You can predict. One thing you could predict immediately is all the shelves and all the stores will go empty immediately.
Yeah.
You know, on a very practical basis, we just tried to imagine, well, what's going to happen if a president of the United States and other world leaders have to go on television and acknowledge UFOs are real because there's been some event or sighting or something? People will go hoard, and some people will loot, and eventually we'll restore order and we'll start to ask a lot of questions and we'll have congressional hearings and news conferences and investigative reports and political realignances and alignments, rather, and it will be a very interesting time. And I'll just give you one final thought on that. We think the decade after disclosure will be closest in form and content to the 1960s as any other decade since. It will spin forces, large and small, into play that are going to cause a very big cultural, some could call it a renaissance and some could call it a revolution, but culturally we will be on fire in that year, those 10 years after.
When all is said and done, I think it just boils down to us being a little bit more in touch with reality and aware of what's around us and how to more positively deal with it. Because that's one thing that defined that generation. Again, we talk about things being trivialized, but people from my generation, the 20s, the 30s, the 40s, I say this every show, there's such a different perspective because we are three generations ahead. And the information, the collective learning, the time that's been allowed for the truth to either be skewed or retold, all of these things have given us a perspective of the 60s as being a flower child, hippie generation. But even though that's true, it's mostly true in the sense that it was a time in which people were probably most susceptible and open to their natural environment.
It'll be the 60s with a technology, just one thought I'd like to leave your audience with, because I've spent so much time thinking about disclosure and how to bring it about and how it becomes a political movement and a civil rights movement instead of a fringe movement. The one thing that Rich and I came to the conclusion after all this consideration was this. We spend a lot of time talking to ourselves. We talk to people who already know what we know or believe what we believe. And for the disclosure movement to succeed, it requires less of that. Certainly, we can talk to ourselves, but it requires not being afraid to talk to your neighbors and your family and your friends and your coworkers about the reality about the current reality and about why disclosure is an important thing to them as well. And that's what we have to start doing. And the other thing we have to do is we have to present ourselves in a way that is less scary. You know, we can't be the fringe crowd. We have to start acting knowing that there's a reality. An extraterrestrial presence is not fringe, it's mainstream. And since it's mainstream, we need to start presenting ourselves in the best possible way. It's time to take the stage, time to turn the page.
One more time, we need everybody to go to the We the People government website and sign up for the disclosure petition in which we need 25,000 signatures before the end of this month. We're going to provide links to that on our site. Please go to those links, take just a few minutes and sign up. Also, we will be working with Bryce and Rich Dolan to put together a campaign in which we ask you, the listener, to... I want you to cover this song. I want you to be as creative as possible. I don't care if you sample it. I don't care if you rewrite it in terms of music. Whatever you do, please keep the lyrics the same and give me that song, because we're going to get this message out without a doubt.
That's fantastic. If people want more information on either of those topics, of course, your site, but also afterdisclosure.com and also ufodisclosuresong.com will have those links that you're talking about to the petition, as well as information about those topics. It's been a pleasure. This has been fun, fun, fun.
I've had a great time, and I really do appreciate your time today. And if we can ever do anything else beyond what we're planning to do to support you, know that we're right there.
Oh, it sounds like you've come up with the most original idea, so keep it up. And to the people who actually do it, if you don't hear me personally say it to you, let me say it now. Thank you very, very much.
Hey, it's my pleasure, more than you know. Thank you for being with me.
Take care.
This is your host, John Zaskoda, and I'd like to take a moment to tell you about a promotion set to launch November 1st. If you're a musician who's ready to have your voice heard in more ways than one, please visit ufodisclosuresong.com and listen to Need to Know, the UFO Disclosure Song. The entire month of November, we're asking that you send in your cover of this song or an original song about UFO disclosure. It doesn't matter what kind of music, country, rap, rock and roll, we want it all. On December 1st, the submission with the most views will receive a signed copy of AD After Disclosure and a gift pack from Stranger Advice, which includes t-shirts, stickers, and much more. Don't hesitate. Go to the URLs listed and start recording your submission. But before you do, be sure to sign the petition today. You say we must wait.